serious, what's a secret you will take to the grave, but don't mind telling on the internet? I had a sweet, wonderful student who had been in foster care, but his mom worked her ass off to get him back, and she did. He had to take a very important city correction, state exam. I have no idea why I wrote city exam, and she called me and asked if he passed it. I looked at the grades and saw he did and said so. She burst into tears of joy, and that is when I saw I had read the wrong score. He had failed. So I changed his grade to passing. No one knew. That was the only time I ever did that. That could have cost me my license. The weird thing is, when my awful corrupt principal pressured me to change other students' scores so we could raise our pass rate, I refused. I never told anyone what I did for my student. He went into the military, was extremely successful there, has a great wife and kids, so I think I did the right thing. FCK those tests, they aren't human. Mentioned before, will never tell anyone I had one of those expensive fancy life-size 6 dolls. Got rid of it at first opportunity, after getting a real partner. But it's literally the only secret I have that I'm not willing to say to anyone in real life. I actually made a new Reddit account, because I will not tell another living soul other than me about this. When I was 7 or 8, I lived in a community where everyone knew each other, and you can pretty much sleep without locking your doors. One night we had bunch of guests over and everyone was having fun conversing. So I asked my mom for some money to buy a candy. There was a convenience store right outside our building, literally 2 steps to the left from when you walk out the apartment. I go inside the store, buy my candy, and head out. As I was walking towards our apartment, a guy grabs my hand and tells me to not scream. I was so scared that I couldn't scream, even if I wanted to. I was 7 or 8. He takes me to a few floors above to a secluded stairway where there are no cameras or people. He pulls down my pants and starts touching my penis. I was confused and scared to understand what his intentions were. He also had something against my neck and kept saying shh. That object could have been a knife, but I have no memory of it. About 5 minutes of him touching me, he goes down one flight of stairs to see if anyone is there. To my luck, he sees an old woman and runs. IDK what it was about that lady, but till this day, I'm convinced that lady was an angel. Had she not been there, the guy would have murdered me. Till this day, no one knows, not even my parents, and I'll keep it that way till death. I used to work for the airport, and so got very discounted fares for friends and family. My mom was going on a trip with her friend to Key West and they were gonna drive, since flying was too expensive. I talked her into letting me handle the flying arrangements and they'd save a ton. A typical $500+ flight turned into like $250 for both of them combined. Well, I was still kinda new at booking reservations and whatnot, and I ended up screwing up the reservation. I think I only booked it for one way or something. So the night before their flight, I rebooked it and paid the $450 for the both of them, money I really didn't have, since never told my mom. It was for Mother's Day, so I figured that was my gift to her. It's been nearly 10 years since. Speaking of grave. When I was a teenager, some friends and I got really stoned and walked around the town cemetery. There was a whole section of generic flat grave markers from the 1800s. I found myself trying to imagine their lives in the same town I lived so long ago. Then I saw one plate kind of sticking up and crooked, and I bent down to touch it. It wasn't attached at all, and I lifted it up in my hand. Right then, my asinine stone teenage brain decided to put it in my backpack. I thought it'd somehow honor this stranger more than the shooty groundskeeper leaving it all willy-nilly in the middle of the aisle. None of my friends saw what I did. Few hours later, sober, and the guilt and panic are setting in. I hid the plate in my closet for about a year before I chucked it back over the fence one day late at night. I hope Bessie Jane Holmes doesn't mind that I kept her for a while. I still think back and shudder at the guilt of such immoral frickery. I attempted to murder my mother. She was abusive, verbally but also physically. She'd hit you in places no one would see, or rip clumps of my hair out when Dad was on the road for work. She probably has a personality disorder. She got in my face one night when I was coming home from my second job, and I had it. My mom like went through whole periods where she wouldn't work. I was killing myself every summer working 50 plus hours to pay family bills in my parents' names and also get my younger sister to all of her activities. I had it. I tried to put mom's head through a wall. She started screaming, "Oh, help, help," and I told her she could dish it out. She should also be able to take it. Shoved her on the ground and kicked her repeatedly in the abdomen and thigh while still trying to put her head through the wall with one hand. It's a plaster and lath situation. Old house in New England. I really fricked her up and it felt good to do so. She's destroyed so many people's lives and she never faces any consequences for it. No one in our family ever helped me or called the police when she would abuse me. The only one who ever helped was the dog, if the dog was awake. When my mom tried to start something, she'd get between us, growl at mom, until she backed down. I had always shown restraint and never hit her until this night. But my dad did call the cops on me when I crossed that line. The cops get there, split us up to interview. I explained my side and then just blurt out, "Where were you assholes when I was 8 and she was doing that to me?" The cop was taken aback. I think he could tell I was being honest, and it was a culmination of years of shoot and pain. He goes and talks to his partner. "I think this isn't an assault. I think it's a mental illness thing." Then they basically intimidated my mom and dad into agreeing with them. They wouldn't let it go until they agreed it was a medical issue, not a criminal one. So they called an ambulance and I went to the hospital as part of a diversion program. Basically, they sent me to detox for 3 days and I emerged with no record, no charges, no nothing except a script for Prozac and a recommendation for therapy paid for by the state low-income insurance plan. Trying to kill my mom probably saved my life, honestly. Because I got myself some tools from a CBT/TBT therapist, but am not stupid enough to want people to know who would date me. How would I ever get promoted at work? Anyway, be kind. You never know what someone's been through, and you never know what people are capable of when pushed far enough. When I was 7, my dad was dating this woman and they seemed pretty happy, but she had a son who would molest me for months in my own room, and eventually lead to him raping me. If I was to have told anyone, that would break up our parents and I didn't want my dad to be sad, so I just took it. Every year I write my parents a Christmas card signed by Sarah and Michael. They still have no idea who they are, and spend a lot of Christmas Day trying to figure it out. Edit, looks like I've ruined the lives of 1000 plus parents. Sorry boomers. I sharted on a New Year's party bus a few years ago. I thought it was just a fart, but it was a small shotgun blast of fluid. I stayed calm and threw away my unders at the next bar. Luckily there was little or no shoot on the inside of my jeans, and I was able to continue the night with no one aware of my poop crime. That my dad paid my mom $1,500 for full custody of my youngest sibling. Not only would this be a massive blow to my sibling, but my dad remarried quite quickly, and the new wife is a very definition of an evil stepmom. If my sibling knew that our mom gave her up for such a small sum of money and the trade-off was 5 plus years of abuse, she would be destroyed. I agreed to a first date with someone to make him stop crying. 6 years later we're happily engaged and doing great. I don't know how well he remembers that, but him not bringing it up. Edit, not that it matters much, but him a dude lol. As a teenager, I had cancer multiple times and nearly died a lot. At one point, I spent several weeks in intensive care and survived despite no doctor thinking that I possibly could live. More than 20 years later, everyone I know still comments on how I survived purely on will to live. I actually spent every moment in that hospital bed in absolute agony, desperately wanting to die. Edit, thank you to the kind folks for my first Reddit awards, and for all of the kind words. I'm healthy now and doing well. So my grandfather had a hand in making one of the World Series trophies back in the day. He never got any credit, but we have photos and parts from his prototype. When I was a teen I added what I knew to Wikipedia, since why not, although I believe it's gone now, but funny story, I ended, but being counted in newspapers all over the country. Proceed to a few years later I get a call from my mom Hoss almost in tears of joy. She found that wiki page, and was freaking out. She was so happy he finally got credit. She ended up making really fancy shadow boxes of the wiki page printed out, copies of the photos and other baseball stuff. She made one for each of her siblings. I've had to just bite my tongue every time I go over there and see this thing hanging prominently in the living room. Seems like a good time as any to tell this story. When I was a teenager, my parents were divorced yet lived within walking distance of each other. I would oftentimes walk back and forth between their homes for whatever reason. I got to know a family that lived in the house on the corner of the block my mother lived on. One day as I was passing this house, I noticed a wallet on the ground. I picked up and opened the wallet. I noticed the address on the ID was the house on the corner, and it was the mom of the family, a very nice lady. Me being a teenager, took all of the money out of the wallet, about $50. I then went back to the home and returned the wallet, explaining I found it down the street. The mother was very relieved and grateful. What always weighed on me is a few weeks later I passed the corner house as I often did, and the lady stopped me. She wanted to thank me for returning the wallet and handed me a $50 bill. I tried to refuse it, but she insisted. I was rewarded for stealing. While it's not a big secret, it is something I always think about for some reason. I've never really had the heart to tell anyone this story. My mother is cheating on my father, and my father is cheating on my mother. They both know I know this, but made me promise not to tell the other parent. Parents are fricked up sometimes. My first car accident back in high school was not because I swerved to miss a deer, like I told my dad and the police. I actually tried to pull the emergency brake and do a 180 while going 50 miles per hour downhill. Had I gone off the other side of the road, I would have gone down a 50-foot hill and into the river. That was the last time I ever tried anything like that. There just so happened to be deer tracks in the mud near the ditch where I ended up. I avoided a ticket and my dad paid to fix my car. I have never told him the truth in the 15 plus years since. My dad cheated on my mom and invited the person over when I was 9. She was a severely overweight woman, and my dad is also quite overweight. My parents were fighting, but trying to work things out. They slept in separate rooms at this point. Earlier that day, I had jumped on his bed and broke the board supporting it on the bed frame. I wasn't allowed to do this and always got in trouble for this reason. My mom smelled the fact that my dad had company because she smoked in my house. She asked if I jumped on the bed. I said no. I feared I'd get in trouble. I was surprised there was no follow-up trying to prove my guilt. Years later, I remember why she asked and realized my lie basically incriminated him to freaking her. I'm sure he did, but that got him kicked out of my house. TL, doctor, I broke the damn bed. I'm a guy. When I was around 9 to 10, I had a friend, also guy, who pushed me up against the wall and started jacking me off. He started doing this frequently and made me masturbate in front of him with one of my parents' personal massagers. I tried to tell on him one time, but went back on it really quickly. I think my mom knew what was going on though. Felt a bit like Stockholm, because he was one of my only friends back then, and I was really scared and confused. Then another friend started dry humping me at a sleepover one time. Being sexualized so early on in life really freaked me up. I was raped with an implement in the youth room of my childhood church by my two best friends at the time. We were basically alone in the building at the time. One did it, and the other held me down. They thought it was a joke slash funny, even once I started screaming. One of them had a moment of clarity and I suppose realized that what they were doing was wrong, and made the other person stop, and they sat there with me for a few minutes until it calmed down. Once I regained myself enough to stand, I racked one of them between the legs with a pool cue. Their parents were waiting in the parking lot, and they were going to call the cops on me until my friend confessed what he'd done to their parents. I was pressured into silence by the pastor at the parents' behest. I've told people, so I guess it's not technically a secret, but nobody's believed me because I'm a big guy, and always have been. The last person I tried to talk to about it actually smacked me in the face, so I guess I'll be dying with this one. Edit a word. Me and my cousin took turns licking each other's assholes when we were about 10 years old. I have vivid memory of it. We have never spoken of it since. We're both 25-year men now. One time, when I was like 10, I went to a Walmart and scratched the backs off of 20 Google Play gift cards without paying and tried using them. My dad left me in the car at a strip club while he went inside and spent almost 2 hours in there. At least he left me with food and water, but he promised me to not tell my mom. I should, but frick it. This post is way too old for anyone to read. That I masturbated to the demo version Outlaw Volleyball on this box back in the day. When I was about 5 or 6, my mother was driving almost 5 miles over the speed limit, and she hit a kid that was about 7. The kid was on the news the next day. Turns out it was my best friend's older sister, Cadlin. I used to be so depressed when I was young. I tried to kill myself and used to puke whenever I was alone in my house because my grandmother and my cousins used to tell me that I was fat, AMD, ugly, and a lot of really bad shoot. I don't have the heart to share that with my parents because they will be heartbroken, and I still haven't get over it completely to discuss it. I grew up without my dad, and I went to meet him this summer for the first time ever. I realized he loves me, but not enough to ever come visit me. Admitting that that makes me sick to my stomach and sad as frick is something I just can't do to anyone. Neither to him. Once when I was 13, I went a week and a half without pooping. I was on a camping trip and something must have happened with the drinking water slash my digestion. Took laxatives, nothing worked. My stomach was killing me but nothing would come out. Then one evening after dinner, I felt it coming. I knew this was it. I bolted for the bathhouse, mentally preparing for the epic event. When I finally waddled in, the stalls were all occupied. At this point I'm freaking out. I'm literally going to shoot my pants, and in the woods with no means of cleaning. I waddle to the private shower attached to the bathrooms and my desperate mind starts solving problems, like I'm Bradley Cooper in Limitless. Initially I think to just shoot on the shower drain and waffle stomp it through, but I was not going to be that guy who ruined the nicest shower in the woods for everyone. Like a bolt of lightning, I knew what I had to do. So I pooped in the only piece of clothing I could spare, my sock. Obviously my stomach was doing better now, and I was hugely relieved. I brought the poop sock to the dumpster nearby, and one of my friends saw me on the way. Before I could dispose of the poop sock, he strikes up a conversation and starts asking questions about what I'm doing. Internally I'm panicking. The best excuse I could come up with was that I found a sock in the shower, stuffed with mud, so I thought it best to throw it away. My friend affirms how good of a guy I'm for doing that. I throw the poop sock into the dumpster and my problems are finally over. Mud in a sock is a ridiculous story, but there's absolutely no way he could have guessed that the real situation was much, much more bizarre. I've never told a soul about this until now. Never will again. Edit. Thanks for the gold and silver.